Tristan had managed to give Tanya the slip, but she had been able to capture his magic glove. The Gauntlet of Finitude, a fabled artifact. Unfortunately, UI overlays don't work in cutscenes, so Tanya couldn't read just exactly what the glove did. Nevertheless, she proudly presented it to the Absolute Evil in its form as the Dungeon Lord. And so misfortune took its course, because at the same time, Tanya wanted to demonstrate how loudly she could snap her fingers. But this snap, which would go down in the history books as the Dungeon Lord snap, unleashed horrific forces that were discharged into the Dungeon Lord himself. As Tanya rose to her feet, the gauntlet had disappeared, and the Dungeon Lord lay dying. Viewers often began to cry at this point, because it made them think back to the last really good superhero movie. Tanya mourned for about 5 seconds. Tanya had shattered the realms of good and served them onto the Absolute Evil on a silver platter, while it had actually done nothing at all. So Tanya now became the Absolute Ruler. She had no clue about how to rule, but more than made up for it with hubris and consistently ignoring glaring problems. In addition, she surrounded herself with a staff of incompetent advisors. What could possibly go wrong? 10 minutes later, Tristan had captured Tanya, locked her in a cage, and put the armies of Absolute Evil to flight. And so the story ends. We'll tell you how the story continues in overpriced microtransaction bites. Oh, wait, wrong script. That's a different developer. Hang in there, I've almost got it. While Tanya was ignominiously taken away, the unused essence of Absolute Evil continued to float through the ether. It wasn't about to admit defeat that easily, but for evil to triumph once again, it needed Tanya back, for better or for worse. And so the swirling essence of Absolute Evil set about commanding the perplexed-looking chaotic hordes and freeing Tanya. Hammer Time! Round 2. The essence of Absolute Evil held the horde together and rose to the challenge of vicious dwarven engineering.
Tristan! Let me out of this damned cage, you stupid little good elf. Otherwise, I'll have a hard time wringing your scrawny neck. What the hell do you want from me anyway?
Tanya, stepsister, your deplorable deeds must not go unpunished. You have slain our foster father, Thanos, a blasphemous affront to our goddess, whom you, to top it all off, have also slain. But we will have plenty of time to argue on our journey. I am here for the stone. Brynhild, if you please.
You know you can, you little cutie. Oi! Go on, you lazy lot. Get that Destroyer of Worlds-class hammer going!
Tanya had been captured. Only the bubbling around the place essence of Absolute Evil could save her. It was amusing to leave Tanya in the clutches of her brother. But on the other hand, without her help, the shapeless evil would probably just roam the countryside as a disembodied something or other and at best be hired for third-rate horror movies. Fortunately, a forgotten dungeon heart lying in the underground could quickly be reactivated. Together with the creatures of the Horde, it would be easy to smash the do-gooder heroes there to smithereens. The wafting evil had to get rid of that dwarven contraption on the overworld, as it posed a threat to the underground, and with it, the dungeon heart. It was therefore necessary to build a mighty dungeon, or rather, to have one built, because as a wafting essence, the disembodied evil could not do much itself. The gold-hungry evil had built a treasury. The meager amount that could be stored in the throne room was simply not even close to enough for a proper gold bar. Loving evil had built a gobbler farm. Here, delicious gobblers were raised to serve as food for the horde. Payday. The sheltering evil had built a hideout for the horde's creatures. These could henceforth build themselves a place to rest there. The army raising evil had recruited its first creature, a bit underwhelming considering that it was sitting on the throne of the gods a short time ago. Fresh starts are never easy. evilest evil could use the hand of terror, not only to intervene, but also to lend its little snots the impetus they needed by giving them a spirited slap. The attitude-adjusting evil had struck one of its little snots. Frightened, the creature squealed and set to work even faster. A new area has been unearthed in the dungeon. Allowing evil had built a tinkerer's cave. Here, little snots could use the work units to make toolboxes, which were needed for the more extravagant dungeon accoutrements.
Set of plans for just how you lot are gonna die here.
day. Creatures are collecting their pay. You have unearthed a new area in the dungeon. A new area has been unearthed in the dungeon. It's payday. Gold vein is nearly exhausted. You have unearthed a new area in the dungeon. A new area of the dungeon has been discovered. You have unearthed a new area in the dungeon. A new area of the dungeon has been discovered. A new area has been unearthed in the dungeon. A new area has been unearthed in the dungeon. It's payday. The detestable evil had earned some delicious evilness. Excellent things could be done with it, such as exploring new stuff. However, first, a place had to be found where the evilness could be stored. The absolute evil quickly built a vault of evilness. The glamorous evil had built a vault of evilness. This allowed it to henceforth store evilness and use it. A new area has
been. Oi! No need to sit around there, please. When we could be picking up a little gold while we're here, eh? On you go, lads! Grab the nearest gold vein.
Sooner or later, the greedy dwarves would dig their way into the dungeon. The perfidious evil used a workshop to prepare traps to stop the gold stealing dwarves in their tracks. Technological progress has almost always been a fine thing. Further research could not only make new units or rooms available, but also increase the maximum number of little snots or creatures. Dwarves had opened a passage into the dungeon. The little snots immediately executed Order 67, as they had been instructed to do by Tanya in such a case, which meant that they ran through the dungeon with their arms flapping wildly. At the same time, they opened the secret trap cache, so that the tricky evil could give the dwarves a very warm welcome.
Oi! Did you little honey buns forget your little baby bottles? Or how did you manage to lose to a bunch of lousy orcs? But boy, we still have some reinforcements here. Reinforcements? Attack!
Obviously, the danger from the dwarves had not yet been neutralized. Luckily, the little snots had made a few traps in their spare time, and they were only too happy to make available to the all-consuming evil. Several snots trapped glittered and gleamed. Soon, gold-hungry dwarves would be biting their teeth out on it as they unknowingly fast-tracked for a quick demise. Ding dong! It's payday! A gold vein has been mined out.
It's payday.
payday. The dwarves were defeated for the time being. Satisfied, the essence of absolute evil rubbed something together that could perhaps pass the two hands together. The all-destroying evil had conquered the exit. This left the way to the surface open for its troops. You have unearthed a new area in the dungeon. A new area has been unearthed in the dungeon. Absolute evil's creatures blinked a little as they stepped into the glaring light of the sun. Finally, they could lay waste not only to the boring corridors of the dungeon, but also to the lush green meadows of the overworld. Horrific evil had destroyed a camp in the overworld. The defeated heroes ran away crying and tried to entrench themselves behind even higher walls. You have destroyed a cage. payday. Evil had destroyed another of the heroes' camps. Screaming at the top of their voices, the survivors took to their heels. The cage was destroyed and creatures were freed.
Machinery here. Well then, keep your chin up, Toodles.
Brynhild, what are you doing? I thought your dwarves could easily handle a few orcs.
Problems, brother mine? Oh, what a shame. I had actually already planned on making myself a tea set out of dwarf skulls.
Talia, your evilness truly knows no bounds. These dwarves are part of the Alliance of Good. You were also once part of that alliance.
The path to the dwarves' oversized hammer lay open. The trembling heroes prepared themselves for the final battle. You have destroyed a cage. Dwarven equipment spectacular. spectacularly went up in flames, which was rather odd, as the creatures had only been hitting the thing with their weapons. But fine, perhaps Horde weapons were made of flint. Yet the distraction provided by the dwarven intervention had shifted the destruction-loving evil's focus long enough for Talia and her stepbrother Tristan to disappear into the distance. With an imaginary sigh, the staggering evil took one last look around before setting off in pursuit. The path led to the Hellwoods, an eerie place claimed by the demonic creatures of the underworld.